Hello, and welcome back to another episode of the Bible in 1 Year at the Preacher's Husband. Today we are going through Song of Solomon, chapters 1 through 8. That's the whole thing. Tomorrow we're going to go through Proverbs 1, 2, and 3. How about that? Now, Song of Solomon. Song of Solomon, actually it could be named any one of three different things. It could be Song of Solomon, as I see in the King James. In the CSB, it's titled Song of Songs. And in other versions of the Bible, it's actually called Canticle of Canticles. Now, the author in all of these, though, is attributed to Solomon himself, which we see in chapter 1, verse 1. Right off the bat, it says the Song of Songs, which is Solomon. This dates to around 965 BC, and the big picture here is a bride and groom, then a wife and husband, celebrate with exuberant passion God's wonderful gift of the love they share by describing the intimate dimensions of their love, physical, emotional, and spiritual. Now, in summary, the Song of Solomon is a celebration of the goodness and beauty of romantic love between a husband and a wife. Several speakers appear throughout this, and it is basically a love song, so to speak. The characters are a woman, a man, there's a chorus of young women from Jerusalem, there's a narrator, and the woman's brothers are also in here. In the song, we see a return to paradise in a courtship that blossomed in the uncluttered beauty of nature. That was in chapter 1 and 2. Then in a wedding night consummated with allusions to the garden of paradise in chapters 4 and 5. And in a marriage that delights in innocent lovemaking in chapters 4, 5, and also in 7 and 8. Now, the song's last praise of love captures all of this together in chapter 8, verses 5 through 7, as it compares the power of romantic love to the eternal fire of God that no waters or rivers can quench. How cool is that? A couple of the verses that stood out to me are the one that's on your screen here. Song of Solomon, chapter 6, verse 3, I am my beloved's and my beloved is mine. This is actually one of the most quoted verses from this book of the Bible. And also chapter 8, verse 7, in the CSB it says, a huge torrent cannot extinguish love. Rivers cannot sweep it away. Now, some people talk about this as being the Bible's romance manual for marriage, and I don't think that's overstating it. I think that could probably be true, because there's a lot of that here. And it even alludes to married couples, basically saying they really should fully explore the sexual dimension of their relationship within within the confines of marriage. You should explore this. This is not a bad thing. It's not dirty. It's not nasty. It's something that, it's a gift that God gave man and woman who are married to enjoy and to appreciate all these things together with each other. Now, on a little deeper, more spiritual level, though, of course, all eight chapters of this book form a key that beautifully depicts the love of a man for a woman and also the love of Christ for his bride, if you think about it in that way. The Song of Solomon is a beautiful love story full of metaphors and imagery, if we look at it from that perspective. While it may be read as a poetic account of intimate love between a man and a woman, its highest value is found allegorically as the depiction of deep spiritual passion and intimacy that exists between Christ and his bride, which is the church. I hope this has touched you. If it has, click the like button and the subscribe button. And of course, click the little jingle bell so you can get notified the next time I upload a video, which will be tomorrow, for another episode of the Bible in 1 Year with the Preacher's Husband. We'll see you then.